What's going on, everyone? My name is Mr. Rage, and welcome back to my channel on this beautiful snowy morning. So in today's discussion video, I'm going to be talking about Rockstar Games and the upcoming GTA 6. In case you haven't already heard, GTA 6 has been officially confirmed by Rockstar. This was actually a while ago, so in case you still didn't know, Rockstar basically confirmed that they are working on the next Grand Theft Auto game, which is, of course, GTA 6, although it may not be, I don't know, but I am not excited for not only GTA 6, but for any game from Rockstar. I guess what you could say is that I just don't really trust this company anymore. And I know what Rockstar fanboys are going to say. They're just going to be like, Rockstar just needs time. And Rockstar has never made a bad game. GTA 6 is going to make billions. Of course it's going to make billions. It's Grand Theft Auto. Okay, Grand Theft Auto is one of the most overrated game franchises of all time. If you think Call of Duty is overrated, no. GTA is overrated. Because let me tell y'all something. Look how bland GTA 5 was. Like, I'm not saying GTA 5 was a horrible game, but GTA 5 was not, like, one of the best games, like, all these Rockstar fanboys want you to believe, or, you know, any other person. You know, GTA 5 was a very bland game. If any other open-world game was as bland and mediocre as GTA 5, do you know how many people would be saying how trash that game is? And how boring it is and how cliche and mediocre it is. GTA 5 was all of those things, and yet people let it get away with it because it has the word Grand Theft Auto in its name, because the name Grand Theft Auto is always going to make money because people are biased. Like, let me explain. GTA 5's open world, I talked about this before in a video where I talked about why GTA 5 was overrated, and I'm going to talk about it briefly right here, but GTA 5 was a very overrated game, and it was a very bland game. The open world in GTA 5 was so boring. Like, Rockstar gave you this big, massive open world to explore and do whatever you want, and yet the open world had literally nothing fun to offer you. The activities in GTA 5 were dog shit. Golf, tennis, yoga. These are things that I would not even want to do in real life. Why the hell would I want to do them in a game? Like, GTA 5's open world was really bad. And I don't mean the open world itself. I mean it was bad because Rockstar had an opportunity to use the massive and giant open world of GTA 5 to offer so many fun things for the player to do. Because what good is an open world game if the open world doesn't even offer you fun things to do as you're exploring the massive open world? That's why when a developer makes an open world game, there has to be plenty of things in that open world for the player to do as they are exploring it or while they're not doing missions. Because while you're not doing missions, the open world is supposed to give you a break to just do whatever you want or do something fun and then do missions again. GTA 5 did not give you any of that because the activities in GTA 5 were shit. All you could really do in GTA 5 that's fun is just killing people. Yes, you could kill people and cause chaos, but even that's gonna get boring after a while. I mean, GTA 5 had such a lack of fun things to do. And the thing that pisses me off the most is the fact that GTA 5's map was so big. I mean, seriously, GTA 5's map is bigger than San Andreas, GTA 4, and the original Red Dead Redemption. That's huge. They could have used that map to give the player so many fun things to do, so many activities, or just, I don't know, like, how about, they even removed gang wars. They removed gang wars. They removed vigilante missions. All of the activities and pastimes in GTA 5 were complete dog shit. The only fun thing you had to do that were kind of fun is when you brought a business and you had to do business missions. That's pretty much it, though. GTA 5 was a very mediocre game. It was a very bland game. It's definitely one of the worst Grand Theft Auto games in the whole franchise. Even the story kind of sucked. Like, I know that Sam and Dan and Hauser and, you know, Leslie, Sam and Dan Hauser, I know that they worked on GTA 5 and they're kind of like the OGs at Rockstar. They've been making GTA games since, you know, Vice City. But honestly, GTA 5, I'm honestly surprised because GTA 5 story, even the story for GTA 5 was kind of bland, especially when you realize that Michael's wife was basically the one that started all the events of GTA 5 because she was banging the tennis coach. Like, seriously, GTA 5 story has so many plot holes. But hey, who cares about the story, right? It's all the gameplay that matters. And you know, hey, I'll give one good credit to GTA 5. The details were amazing, okay? GTA 5 was jam-packed with details. Maybe that's what blinded everyone, you know, because the details were so good. But honestly, if you think details is enough to make a game good, then you are just as stupid as someone who thinks that graphics is enough to make a game good. How the fuck do you want me to appreciate the details if the gameplay itself is boring or just bad? GTA 5's gameplay may not just be bad, but it's still so boring because the game itself is boring. I mean, seriously, what do you do in GTA 5 when you are not doing a mission? You just drive around trying to not get hit by the shitty NPCs that will literally hit your car on purpose and then flick you off as if it was your fault? And not, that's not even talking about the wanted level system. The wanted level system in GTA 5 is so fucking bad. Like, seriously, you have NPCs to fuck with. You could just fuck with the NPCs or just mess with the NPCs. And the minute you knock out more than one person, you get a wanted level. Like, seriously, there are gang hangouts in GTA 5, right? There are parts of the map where gang members have like the Vagos or the Ballas or the Lost, the Biker Gang, and you could go and fight with these guys. You know, you can like have a fist fight with them, and there will be moments where like 5 or 10 guys will all be ganging up on you, getting ready to fight you, and you can't even enjoy it because you get a wanted level. You can't even have a fun street fight. That should have been an activity in this game, like gang street fights or just gang fights, just like in the original GTAs. GTA 5 was such a shitty game. And this is one of the reasons why I'm not excited for GTA 6, especially because of the quality of Rockstar. Seriously, you cannot expect me to be excited for a game from a company that has released 3 games on 3 different consoles, and the third time, they couldn't even release it in good condition. In case you didn't know, for you idiots out there who actually did buy GTA 5 Expanded and Enhanced, then you'll realize that it was full of bugs and glitches at launch. Like, seriously, GTA 5 was released a third time, and Rockstar couldn't even do it the right way this time. Like, seriously, how do you release the same game 3 times, and on the third time you release it, for the third time, you couldn't even do it right this time? Because seriously, GTA 5 was filled with bugs and glitches. And you know what? It still has bugs and glitches. You wanna know why? Because I have GTA 5 Expanded and Enhanced on my PS5. Because of course, I also bought a PS5 because I got stupid these past couple of months. We're not gonna be talking about Sony and their greedy asses though. But anyways, yeah, I am not excited for GTA 6 because the quality of Rockstar has just fallen so low. And like I said, I know what Rockstar fanboys are going to think. Rockstar has never released a bad game. Every game that Rockstar releases is a banger. Okay, if that's the case, then why is GTA the Trilogy Defective Edition defective? I want you Rockstar fanboys to give me an explanation. And I want you to give me an explanation that's not bullshit, that came out your ass, and an actual valid explanation to everything that Rockstar has done in the past couple of years that has been completely scummy, completely anti-consumer, and a complete punch in the face to gamers and to me and to everyone who plays their shit in general. I want a valid explanation from you, because if you're such a big Rockstar fan, then do your job and defend them. But don't defend them with your bullshit. Defend them with a logical explanation that actually makes sense. Oh, don't let me guess. I already know. GTA the Trilogy was not made by Rockstar. It was made by Grove Street. Why did Rockstar hire Grove Street? And not only that, but why didn't Rockstar themselves try and fix it? If Grove Street fucked up GTA the Trilogy Definitive Edition, why didn't Rockstar try and fix it themselves after they fucked it up? Or why didn't they hire another developer to try and fix it? Or why did they release GTA 5 for the third time? Let's be honest. Rockstar did not release GTA 5 for any other reasons besides to milk GTA Online for just a little while longer while we wait patiently for GTA 6 to also suck just as much as GTA 5 did. Look, I'm not saying GTA 6 is going to suck, but I honestly doubt it's going to be as good as GTA 4. It may even be worse than GTA 5, who knows? Because GTA 5 was not as good as GTA 4. And I already know what you Rockstar fanboys are thinking. But
you could customize your car in GTA 5. You could get haircuts.
You do realize you could do all those things in GTA San Andreas as well, right? Hell, in GTA San Andreas, you could actually learn karate. And your character would actually get fat for eating at the restaurants. You don't even have restaurants in GTA 5. That's how fucking bland it is.
But your characters has special abilities.
So what? Your character also had special abilities in Red Dead Redemption and the original Max Payne games. Who the fuck cares? Calm down. Calm down, Mr. Rage. You Rockstar fanboys really pissed me off. You know why? Because you are probably the reasons why Rockstar is able to get away with all the shit that they have been getting away with these past couple of years. Because you fucking cunts defend them like Rockstar is your goddamn god or sugar daddy. Like, seriously, what is wrong with you people? You see a company that is clearly shitting all over your face and pissing in your mouth down your throat, and you're okay with it. You don't get away from that. You go to it. You give them more money for doing that shit to you. You give them money for literally pissing down your throat and shitting in your face. And literally fucking you in the ass afterwards. What is wrong with you people? You Rockstar fanboys are some of the most pathetic pieces of shit motherfuckers I have ever seen. I wish I could actually inflict physical harm upon you people. I know that sounds psychotic and immature, but you people fucking deserve it. You people are ruining the gaming industry by supporting companies like this that not only don't care about video games, but are literally using them just to make money off of people who do. In that case, us the gamer. You Rockstar fanboys are a fucking joke. Your lives are a joke. Kill yourselves. No one will miss you. Jump. Get on a building and jump. Or take some pills. Overdose on Adderall. Take a gun to your head and blow your brains out because you clearly don't have any anyways.
Okay. I'm done. I'm done. But yeah, I am not excited for GTA 6, okay?
It's not just because GTA 5 was mediocre, okay? Because let me calm down a little bit. Let me put my rage away. Red Dead Redemption 2 was a good game. And I remember when Red Dead Redemption 2 first came out, I was like, man, it's just like the old days. First we got GTA 5, now we got another banger, Red Dead Redemption 2. Maybe then we'll get Bully 2 after. You know, Rockstar was making bangers just like they used to be. And I was like, man, we even got GTA Online. We got Red Dead Online. It's all good. We got a new Rockstar that still makes great games. And now we even have some fun online content. Because back then, I actually liked GTA Online. I used to play it with my friends, you know? Even my cousin used to play it with me. So I was alright with GTA Online back then when Red Dead Redemption 2 first came out. And I was also excited for Red Dead Online. Of course, we all know how that turned out. Rockstar's quality has dropped so low. It's not just the fact that Dan Houser is gone, and so is Leslie Benzies, but not only that, but it's also the fact that Rockstar has re-released two of their older games, GTA 5 and then GTA the Trilogy, which is actually four games because, you know, GTA 3, Vice City, and San Andreas. And Rockstar couldn't even do this right. They couldn't even scummily release three, or no, they couldn't even release two, or no, four, right? Because, you know, GTA 3, Vice City, San Andreas, case, GTA Trilogy. They couldn't even release three of their older GTA games, as well as GTA 5. And seriously, one thing that pisses me off the most is how did Rockstar re-release GTA 5 and they couldn't even do it right this time? How is it that the Xbox One and PS4 version of GTA 5 runs better and is less buggy than GTA 5 for PS5 and Series X? Or in this case, GameStation 5 and Xbox Series L? Like, only next-gen consoles gets this shit. Okay, back in the Xbox 360 era, you never had to deal with this type of shit. I'm telling you. Modern gaming is so fucking bad. I mean, think about it. Modern gaming is trash. We have overpriced, unfinished games. Our best developers are now shit. Modern gaming is so garbage.
And, you know, there's just so much wrong that could go with GTA 6. And, yes, I saw the leak. I don't care if you play as a woman, okay? Didn't people want that? And didn't people already predict that the next GTA was going to have a female character? But now, oh, GTA is going woke. You fucking wanted a female character. Didn't you people want a female character? Well, you got her now, okay? That's not the problem. The problem with GTA 6 that I'm worried about is the quality of the game. I don't want GTA 6 to be another bland mess like GTA 5. I want GTA 6 to be a classic Grand Theft Auto game. I want it to have everything that the older GTAs had, but better and more modernized and more than what they had, while at the same time bringing back the things that made the old games good, while bringing new things into the formula. GTA 6 needs to have new activities that are actually fun, good mechanics, and most importantly, it needs to have things to do in the open world. You cannot have a good open world game if the open world is boring. Because what good is an open world if the exploration is the only thing about it that you actually do with the open world? Let me tell you something. Exploration is boring. Exploring is boring unless you're actually having fun while you're exploring. That's why open world games need to offer plenty of fun things to do for the player as they explore the open world, while finding plenty of fun things to do in the open world that are put there by the developers. That's how you make a good open world game, and GTA 5 did not have that. GTA 5 is honestly downright frustrating. You get a wanted level for literally everything you do. You can't even mess with the shitty NPCs that will definitely fuck with you, because of course in GTA 5 the NPCs are fucking garbage. They will drive into you on purpose and flick you off. They will start fighting with you for no reason, just for literally standing right next to them. GTA 5 has details. Fuck your details. Honestly, fuck your details, you stupid Rockstar cuckboys. Fuck your goddamn details. I will put in detail how you are a piece of shit. Like I said earlier, kill yourself. If GTA 6 ends up being a good game, I will be pleasantly surprised. But one thing that I am already predicting, GTA 6 will not have any single player content and will instead focus on GTA Online 2, I guess, whatever they're going to call it, like GTA 6 Online, just GTA Online again, I don't know, but it's not going to have any single player content, and it is not going to be as good as GTA 4. If it's worse than GTA 5, I will officially stop playing AAA games. I swear to God, man. It's sad that I am more excited for Resident Evil 4 Remake than anything from Rockstar. I would never guess in a million years during my time being 13 years old that I would be sitting here telling you guys that Rockstar Games is shit and GTA 6 would probably be shit as well. I used to be such a big Rockstar fan back in the day, but these days, not anymore. It's honestly because of the quality. And I already know what you Rockstar fanboys are thinking. But GTA 6 has been in production for so long. It's been development for so long. It's going to be great. Okay, smartass. If GTA 6 is going to be so good, then why was GTA 5 Expanded and Enhanced made? Why was GTA the trilogy made? Why is Rockstar doing all this shit and yet you expect them to actually make GTA 6 good? Didn't a bunch of employees actually stop working at Rockstar because they were being overworked for Red Dead Redemption 2? Like, what's GTA 6 gonna be like now? You know what? Never mind. I don't have faith in Rockstar anymore. You know, it's like I'm a Christian who's been through too much hell to have any more faith in God. I just cannot trust this company anymore. I mean, I hope that GTA 6 will be good. I hope it exceeds my expectations. But until I actually see it myself, I am not excited for GTA 6. I just can't. I just can't see myself being excited for it. Because between the fact that GTA 5 was bad and now Rockstar is doing all this scummy shit, the only thing that could maybe prove that GTA 6 will be kind of good is honestly Red Dead Redemption 2. Because Red Dead Redemption 2 was a good game. It was way better than GTA 5. The open world was a little better than GTA 5. There was some more fun things to do. You know, it was more realistic. So Red Dead Redemption 2 was a good game. I will admit, Red Dead Redemption 2 was a fantastic game, actually. The story was great. The gameplay was great.
I'm not really a fan of Western games, but even I still enjoyed Red Dead Redemption 2 because I loved that movie, Cowboys vs. Aliens. Huge horror fan, by the way, in case you didn't already know that. So Red Dead Redemption 2 was a decent game. Or not a decent game, it was a great game. GTA 5 was a decent game. You know, the only good thing about GTA 5 is honestly the combat. The combat, the customization, the details, the special abilities, all those things were okay about GTA 5. But honestly, man, GTA 5 was just such a shitty game. You know, it was not really a good game, to be honest. So GTA 6, I don't really know, man. I mean, I want to say I'm slightly excited for GTA 6. I'm definitely waiting for GTA 6. I'm only waiting for it so I could see how it turns out. I mean, when it first comes out, the internet's going to go crazy. Like, when it first comes out, everyone is going to go crazy. The internet is literally going to burst into flames, and they're going to have to call the internet fire department to put it out, right? It's going to be just as big as GTA 5. But once the heat dies down and once the hype dies down, maybe then I'll see it for myself. Maybe then I'll buy and I'll see what it's like, but my expectations are not high though, you know, because I just can't really expect anything good from Rockstar anymore. I've lost my faith in this developer, my favorite developer I no longer trust. Saying that honestly brings tears to my eyes because Rockstar used to be one of my favorite developers back in the day. Hell, Rockstar Games and the GTA franchise was probably the things that kept me going when I was a kid, you know, because I still had my mental illness when I was a kid. So the GTA franchise was, you know, it was important to me. It was really important to me. So, yeah. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about this video. Are you excited for GTA 6? What do you think about modern Rockstar? I honestly can't say anything good about them. I mean, except for some updates for GTA Online. Although that's still not right because they abandoned Red Dead Online. But hey, I guess at least you could sell your car going in a private lobby in GTA Online, I guess, you know. Hooray, you know, more grinding in GTA Online for nothing. But anyways, thank you guys so very much for watching. If you stuck by till the end and if you heard my angry ranting, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think about Rockstar Games. Are you excited for GTA 6? And be sure to leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think, and I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe. It really helps out the channel. A huge shout out to all my new subscribers, by the way. Thank you guys so much for subscribing to my channel. I never thought I would get this far to 384 subs. So, yeah. But anyways, thank you guys so much, and I will see y'all in my next video. This is Mr. Rage signing off. Bye-bye, guys, and have a good one.